Rage raged across the African continent in 2019, with no signs of cooling down in 2020. In Sudan and Guinea, they were manifestations of frustration with entrenched leadership. In Zimbabwe, they mostly centered around anger over economic conditions. In Cape Town, rural Ethiopia, and the eastern Congolese town of Beni, they were about the rights of communities displaced by conflict. Human Rights Watch launched this year's Africa Rights Report in Johannesburg this week to report on the year in human rights.
We've seen, I think, the average men and women of the African continent taking agency, being agents for their own, for the changes they wanted to see. We saw an increase of peaceful protest in different countries. The second, I think, takeaway is that we've also seen a backsliding from government in terms of political and civic space.
That has taken the form of outright police aggression and repression, as seen in Southern Africa.
We expected more from Southern African leaders, including President Ramaphosa of South Africa, based on their commitments and promises to fulfill people's rights across the region. But we saw that there was a constriction of space for human rights defenders. In countries like Zimbabwe, there was a clampdown on protesters, excessive use of force by the police and the other arms of the security forces. There was no accountability whatsoever.
There was a glimmer of hope as Ethiopian Prime Minister Abiy Ahmed won the Nobel Peace Prize for his reform agenda and for his reconciliatory moves with arch-enemy Eritrea. But the group's Africa Advocacy Director echoed concerns that the award was premature.
He's done quite a few great things in Ethiopia. He's released political prisoners. He's actually reforming some repressive laws. He sort of made peace with Ethiopia, with Eritrea. So things are moving in the right direction, mostly. But there's still a lot to be done in Ethiopia.
Overall, it was, experts say, an extraordinary year.
Who could have thought al-Bashir in Sudan would be overthrown? Who could have thought that would happen in Nigeria, in Africa? We're sort of looking at the Arab Spring. So people are being more aware of their rights to demonstrate, to protest.
But Mavinga says the people can't do this alone. He pointed to the nation with the continent's most progressive constitution, which is taking up the rotating chairmanship of the African Union this year.
South Africa has to step up to the plate. It has to deliver on human rights and draw back on Mandela's legacy. But we will have to continue to push.
That, they say, they will do. Because as 2019 made clear, people are behind them. Anita Palviyo, News, Johannesburg.